Hello, everybody. I hope everything's working. Shout out me if not. Hello, TND Tesla, Sean Donnelly, everybody else. Sorry for being a little bit late.
Shout out me if not.
Yeah, we have audio. Wonderful. So people have been barking at me for more NVIDIA content, more AI content, more stuff on semiconductors, more stuff on Tesla, etc. And are these things now toast because of the tariff war? So I build content around what you ask for, and it seems like people are losing or giving up the ghost on crypto and they want to hedge their bags. And that's exactly what I do too. So I'm all in on two narratives, crypto and AI. I tend to talk more about crypto because it's fascinating, but even more fascinating, but yet more complex is AI and all the stuff happening in the world. So as promised, I'll do more of that. So thank you to everybody all over the world. I got people. James is coming live from the shower. I wish I had time to take a shower, to be honest. Anyway, let's get into this story, everybody. This is going to be interesting. So first of all, not financial advice, and shout out to Patreon. First of all, it's pretty clear the world is in a world of hurt. Manufacturing index here from Lizanne Saunders continues to tank. We are definitely in a recession. I've been talking about this for months. Definitely many industries are in recession, but some are really being hit right now and people are concerned about their AI bags. Does all of this tariff tension impact those items as well? And that's what we're going to try and understand today. So no doubt, and I think it was Rick Reeder from BlackRock came out today, said, yeah, we're in a recession, everybody. That's why gold is going to the moon. Everybody is terrified. The question is, will AI survive? And that's really what I want to try and address here today. Also, you get a lot of kind of FUD-like stuff here, like from Reuters. It's the new fake news central sometimes that people say, allegedly. NVIDIA says U.S. government has banned H2O chips to China. And NVIDIA expects up to $5.5 billion charge in the first quarter. Yes, this reads quite alarming out there, everybody. So let's dig into exactly what this is all about. First of all, shout out to AJ as well. AJ knows his stuff. He is a top-notch analyst out there. So follow him on Twitter. His name is @Aloja. But the query, is there enough demand backlog to sop up the temp loss of China for HDOs and etc.? Likely, I think yes, in my humble opinion. And AJ responds, please see my other post. I reflected the H2O impact. I estimate H2O had up to 16 to 17 billion in demand, potential left before end of life. And Uranium Chicken has a very good point of view too. He says, China going to get those chips one way or another. And we saw that happening actually back in 2024, where you got firms like DeepSeek using NVIDIA, a bunch of chips, they were in China. How do they get them? The answer is probably through the black market in Singapore. And that's why Singapore is one of the biggest markets for NVIDIA chips. So there you have it. Again, I think Uranium Chicken is correct. If there is a will, there is a way. And money can make anything happen. And another note here from AJ regarding an exchange he had with a subscriber. And he considers that NVIDIA export news as completely immaterial due to the rest of the world demand far exceeding supply. None of AJ's forecasts ever included any sales to China, and he's got a lofty target for NVIDIA as well. And there's no change to any forecasts, it's just a red herring. And as usual, the media loves to sell fear. They live on fear and death because that's what sells. That's what people click on, etc. That's why we don't do clickbait here. We just share news and we don't alarm people unnecessarily. So let's move on and see what else is going on. Let's look at some numbers. This is China, including Hong Kong, revenue split for NVIDIA. You can see that the numbers vary. They go up to about 14%, 12%, 18%, 10%, depending on the actual quarter and the month, down as low as 7%. So it's not that big a deal. And remember, China and Hong Kong, although part of the same place, different territories. And sometimes people in Hong Kong can get things out of Singapore if they want them to. Hello, Solbull, and everybody out there, and TND Tesla once more again. So again, it's not a, you know, I wouldn't call it a nothing burger, but where there's a will, there's a way, and money can be pulled from different sources. Also, if you look at this chart here, again, While China is not dominant, the CAGR is 29% for chips in China, compound annual growth rate. We always talk about rate of change and why that's so important. But the question is, CAGR 29%, what is the rest of the world doing? Well, if we look at some of the other CAGRs, for example, USA 44%. And guess what? The CAGR for Singapore is 223%. And that's why I say where there's a will, there's a way. And you know that when China wants H2Os, H100s, B200s, etc., they can get them somehow. Solbo, you rock. Thank you. So let's get on to the story here as well. And Dan Ives, shout out to Dan. His thoughts on NVIDIA H2O China restriction. Get used to this news flow in US-China tariff battle, but it's a game of high stakes poker and need to buckle seatbelt. Look past the chaos. NVIDIA is the only AI chip in the world and demand is not the issue. It's interesting the way Dan actually discounts AMD. They have their own version of an AI chip, which is not nowhere near as good as NVIDIA, but it is somewhat functional. Anyway. Dan is on the same page as Aloja, which is on the same page as Logic. So yeah, do not believe the FUD. That's why I bought the NVIDIA dip heavily. We will look at some charts as well real soon. But before we do, Jensen Huang is in Beijing. And this is kind of interesting. Amid the new US restrictions, and you know, Jensen has to be careful, but he's in China. We have an AI czar, his name is David Sachs, who is also the crypto czar, and he has the ear of the leadership of the United States. So, you know, Jensen, the CEO of NVIDIA, wouldn't go to China unless he knew it was safe to go, and especially with the restrictions of H2O artificial intelligence chips to China. And he's meeting Ren Hongbin, who is the head of the China Council for Promotion of International Trade, which is big news. But Jensen is not only there meeting the leadership of China, but also players like the founder of DeepSeek, Lian Wenfeng, who is the DeepSeek founder, as to how they can maybe collaborate together, work together, etc. Again, if a nation wants chips, they will find a way to get their hands on them. All this, you know, embargoes and restrictions and sanctions, etc., don't matter a hill of beans. It's like if the Russians want to sell natural gas to a BRICS country, they can do it for crypto. Then you need to use Swift or the dollar. Again, the technology is there for people to work around. Stephen Weston, good to see you. And Piper, too, up there in Canada. So this is so interesting. Again, Jensen Huang, CEO of NVIDIA, one of the richest men on the planet, is out there in China, meeting with the Chinese leadership and DeepSeek, which caused the irony. You can't make this stuff up. DeepSeek caused the huge initial dip in NVIDIA in the first place. It's like, ooh, we found a new way of going straight to the metal in a chip, bypassing the CUDA software. And that would in turn increase the power of existing chips so there'd be less demand for them. Of course, that was ended up not being true. But the media had a field day as usual. Again, they sell fear. And speaking of DeepSeek as well, this is so cool. You know, Baseden is now offering inference on the B200s. Okay. They are ideal for workloads and aggressive throughput, very low latency, and very low cost as well. Again, the B200s compared to the H100s are 5x higher throughput, 50% lower cost per token, and 38% lower latency for the largest language models. And now B200 GPUs, you can run models like DeepSeek, Llama, and Qwen to power code generation, etc. Everybody needs this. Everybody wants this. Everybody has to get their hands on these chips. Okay, so that's a big message. And let's look at NVIDIA on the ATR. If we look at the chart here before we get into some of the other stories that impact all of this whole chip tariff tantrum, etc., you can see the price of NVIDIA fell beautifully down and bounced clean off level 4. Boom. There's one of two names that bounced clean off certain layers, and that shows you very strong support. That is about $88, $89. So congratulations to everybody who nibbled at that level. But again, we're just about $100 now and still holding in, but down off the highs quite a bit. You know, will we return when all of this settles down? The answer is yes. Now, more Reuters FUD, re-Tesla Robotaxi chips. This is another kind of interesting piece. So you can see, but this is from Jeff Lutz, friend of the channel. Reuters writes a stupid, unsourced article about delays due to prototype parts. And of course, they select Tesla to make up the story about when every tech company on the planet prototyping pre-SOP are getting passives and other electric components from China, which are mostly carved out from the tariffs. And for Tesla, low dollar values. Again, Tesla or Reuters love to jump on companies' graves, especially companies like Tesla, and saying, woohoo, yeah, okay, spreading all this FUD, that Robotaxi would delay because they can't get their hands on the chip. You think Tesla doesn't plan for this type of eventuality? No. Anyway, the point is, be careful what you read out there and watch what happens. So, and then Tesla also, you know, because we're talking about H100s and B200s, Tesla's also doubling down on their own Dojo supercomputer, which is basically a series of chips that is optimized for learning from video and other things. 10% of FSD learning, is the full self-driving, is done using Dojo. And this is another interesting little twist to this kind of story here, is the fact that I think it was Morgan Stanley, their analyst, says Dojo. Obviously, they need to build their own Dojo to reduce reliance on NVIDIA GPUs. What happens if NVIDIA run out? Then Tesla's high and dry. And also the NVIDIA GPUs are costly and in very high demand. But Morgan Stanley estimate the Dojo could add at least $500 billion to Tesla's market cap. Just their Dojo project, which basically nearly makes up the entire market cap of Tesla today. So imagine when this rolls out, or if they get to a position where they can do compute as a service using Dojo chips for other companies to learn. Imagine you've got a car company that wants to do some FSD type learning, etc. So we'll see if Morgan Stanley's right. Tesla has recently emphasized its Cortex supercomputer running Dojo, and Dojo is the key for this as well, big part. So anyway, of course, Cortex is 90% running NVIDIA chips, but at the same time, interesting to watch. If they pull it off, that would be incredible. Remember, all that NVIDIA does is chips. Imagine Tesla make a chip as good as NVIDIA's. Technically, you could argue the market cap should be $2.5-3 trillion based on just this chip business alone called Dojo. So we'll see where it all goes. And Tesla on the ATR, again, Tesla bounced clean off level 3, not like level 4, which is where NVIDIA showed very good support. Tesla's beaten down a little bit more, but if you look back at the journey since 2020, it's been pretty impressive. We had a big new all-time high around the 18th of December, if I recall. And we've fallen down for a number of different reasons, much of them driven by the media, driving a lot of fear through the heart of Tesla, a lot of terror, a lot of, oh, Q1 numbers are really bad, while ignoring the fact that most of the factories around the world were closed for 4 to 5 weeks. Anyway, that's just the media. So shout out to them. They're great for giving us low prices. So we are grateful for that. Also, SpaceX, Palantir, and Anduril are teaming up. This is a kind of an interesting twist of a story. It's a little bit adjacent to AI and everything else, but it's not. It's basically how these companies, Palantir, AI company, Tesla, AI company, Anduril, a defense system company, missile company, a new modern Silicon Valley kind of technology company, but they will be teaming up to build the Golden Dome, which is a U.S. missile defense system. And SpaceX is also pitching a subscription model to the Pentagon with 400 to 1,000 satellite constellation capabilities as well. So you begin to see how everything is connected. Can you imagine what happens next with autonomous robots and self-driving vehicles, whatever they may be? Again, the future is going to be very terrifying and exciting all at the same time. So let's talk about TSMC as well. This is a very important point to note regarding all of this FUD regarding chips. And this comes at a little bit of a different angle from Shay Ballour. The market keeps misreading TSM. They're the gatekeeper of the post-CPU era. Remember, we're in the GPU era. And the packaging bottleneck is now a system-wide bottleneck. You can have the chip, you can have the design, but without access to TSMC's packaging, which means their ability to hammer it together, your accelerator doesn't go to market. It's that simple, okay? Why do we care about TSMC? Because they are the ones that make the things, okay? The companies like NVIDIA, they design them. TSMC make them. The inference chips for Tesla, they are made by TSMC. Dojo is made by TSMC. TSMC make it all. And TSMC are going to be deploying a new factory in the United States, I think, soon, if not already. And the other good news to prove that all of this is nonsense is tariffs have not impacted TSMC at all yet. The guidance is still very strong. The sales are very, very strong. Again, not a problem, not a concern at all, despite what you read out there. Spartan, thank you so much for coming. This is TSMC and the ATR. It's actually holding up better than NVIDIA, believe it or not. And it's been on a rampage. This puppy has 5X since 2020. And it is dipping, but it's at probably about level 4.3, 4.4. And it's holding up stronger than NVIDIA and holding up stronger than Tesla. So that's a good sign. The market is understanding their numbers. And shout out to Pelosi, Nancy Pelosi, great, great trader, great investor. Don't know how she does it at all, but she has a nice big bag of NVIDIA, making up about 16% of her holdings. And obviously, she understands the importance of AI and how AI will become strategic to nations going forward. Remember, a government in the future, if they do not have a solid foothold in AI, like I mentioned before, look at this. This slide was at number 18. Pull that back again, just to give you an idea. SpaceX, Palantir, and Anduril are teaming up for the US government to build a Golden Dome missile defense system, okay? It is absolutely critical. And our top politicians like Nancy Pelosi understand that too. That's why they're placing big bets on this space. And welcome to meme of the day. Kramer says NVIDIA is no longer a stock. You can he thinks it's going to go down. But you know the inverse, Kramer. It means it's going to go up, everybody. So take that to the market. He's as inversely reliable as Nancy Pelosi is reliable. Anyway, thank you all for coming, everybody. Hope you have a great Thursday. Sean D, TND Tesla, all the brilliant mods out there in the chat, and everybody from all over the world. We've got New Zealand, we've got Australia, we've got Netherlands, Germany, and as the LAX guy says, you will never meet a poor politician. Correctamundo, correctamundo. I heard AOC has made, she went from being poor in 5 years to being worth $28 million on a salary of 170 grand. There you go. Good money in politics if you can get it. Love you too, American Beijinger. You all be safe out there. Have a good night. Talk to you tomorrow. Bye-bye.